It'd taken more than you said, trying hard not to awaken the voice of regret in his ear. He can't escape.
Centered in front of their Matthews. They score!
It's Schultz going right in, waiting for the two-point score!
Lived every moment.
In for Sundin. Nice move!
Thank you to Eddie Vedder for the open. In the NHL, there's only the long way to success. No easy games, no easy weeks, as the Leafs were reminded on Monday as their five-game win streak came to an end. They'll look to turn the page on that as they take on the Flyers in Philadelphia. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey, presented by Molson, Craig McTavish, Anthony Stewart, Carolyn Cameron with you. The big news is that the Toronto Maple Leafs for tonight will be without their captain, John Tavares, who was injured in Monday's game against the Kings. So that means, obviously, changes to the lineup. Alex Kerfoot, he'll play center on that second line, and that means opportunity for Nick Ritchie.
It doesn't look like as strong a line right now. It's going to be a big loss for Tavares being out, but it's a great opportunity for Nick Ritchie. But Sheldon will have the hair trigger on. If this thing isn't working early or Nick doesn't show the intensity that's expected out of the coach, there'll be a move made quickly.
Yeah, no better way to break that slump in playing with Mitch Marner, who's the hottest hand in the National Hockey League right now. So all he's got to do is go to the net and tap, tap, tap it in.
Yep, Mitch Marner looking to extend his six-game point streak. It's the Leafs and Flyers coming up after the break with Chris Cuthbert, Craig Simpson, and Sean McKenzie.
So the Maple Leafs and Flyers from Wells Fargo tonight. First meeting in 708 days between these two teams on Military Appreciation Night. And an NHL debut for Kirill Semyonov, who gets into the lineup with the absence of the captain here tonight.
Yeah, big loss with John Tavares playing his best hockey of the year, but as always, someone's got to step in, take the role, and an opportunity, as Craig McTavish mentioned, for Ritchie up on that line.
Jack Campbell at one end, that's Carter Hart knocking it down. At the other end, behind the Flyer net, David Camp starts. Andre Kasha good to go with Pierre Engvall tonight. And for the Flyers, it is Derek Brassard out there along with Cam Atkinson and Joel Farabee. And Justin Hall back in the lineup after missing five. Atkinson a shot, rebound loose, and back-to-back stops early for Jack Campbell in the opening 30 seconds after the Leafs said they wanted a better start than we saw against the Kings on Monday night. Travis Sanheim off the boards. That'll ricochet off Camp, and now the Leafs start a change. And here's a steal from Michael Bunting, testing Hart for the first time tonight, and he'll hold on.
Well, a little game of turnovers here early on, and one in the Leafs zone. You started the Justin Hall getting back into his first game. He gets pressure twice there, an errant pass turns into one shot, but then Campbell able to find that rebound and get a good active stick and lower pad. At the other end, a turnover, and Bunting got his first shot on Carter Hart.
Austin Matthews wins a draw. Back to TJ Brody, reunited with Morgan Riley. That one bounced through, and Hart able to hold on to that as the Leafs get a chance off a faceoff win.
Well, Chris, so much has been made about the lack of goal scoring by the Leafs defense. Just one goal, and that's Jake Buzzin back on October 30th. But that was good movement laterally coming down the side for Morgan Rielly, and gets a good hard shot on goal.
Ivan Provorov sends it out to center. The pass cut off by Brody. Now Morgan Rielly fed it up onto the left side. Bunting went sprawling. Brody stepped up. The puck jumped on him. And now picked up by Sean Couturier, who sends it to the right side. That's Giroux on the ice along with Konechny. Travis Konechny, Claude Giroux. The captain goes to the front of the net. And Sean Couturier, the youngest Flyer to ever hit the 700 game mark, puck over the glass, but deflected out of play.
Well, Couturier, such an important player. He scored the game-winning goal against Washington in their last game. And, you know, a good offensive start. All the key players for the Philadelphia Flyers have been off to good starts. There's quite a trio there, as Dave Poulin back in 87, and of course the captain, Bobby Clark, such a great two-way player in history of the Philadelphia Flyers. What an honor it was for Couturier in 2020.
Faceoff control by Philadelphia. Sanheim sent it to the net. Knocked down there by Kerfoot. Lilligren behind the net. That popped high in the air. It'll be gloved down by Kerfoot. And a delayed penalty coming up against Philadelphia.
Campbell's just staying to make sure there's no errant passes here before he makes his way like that.
Drop back to Kerfoot, and he'll start out through center ice. Matthews has jumped up on the play, and Matthews was in behind the defense, and the puck popped over his stick, and now the first penalty call, just 2:02 into the game.
Len Vigneault said coming into this game, you have to be wary of the power play of the Toronto Maple Leafs. It's been on a hot streak, scoring five in a row, and the one thing you don't want to take is that. The stick gets wrapped around, and Lawton tried to get it and drop it quickly, and Kerfoot just kept his feet moving, and that created the chance. So this hot power play that's been clicking away at 50% for the last five games gets an opportunity to get one early.
6-for-12 over that span, 2-for-14 on the road, as it is controlled by the Leafs off the faceoff. Nylander to Matthews in the middle. Nick Ritchie sets up in front on the eight power play unit, and here's a chance. Nylander stopped by Hart from in tight.
Now you see the reaction of Nylander. There's really only one option. The puck's lying right there. He gets to skate into it, but that little delay allows Hart. He's trying to look around the body of Ritchie, get side to side, and while the puck was there, now he's square. And no extra movement there for Carter Hart, and Nylander not able to find a hole.
23-year-old goaltender, 2-0 in his career against Toronto. And the Flyers get a clear. Campbell will set it up back behind his net for Morgan Rielly. So without John Tavares, a chance for Ritchie here on the first power play unit. Takes the pass from Marner. Along the boards, he'll sweep it around to the near side. Nylander is there trying to drop it off, but intercepted by Couturier with Nate Thompson. Here's the veteran Thompson for the rebound. Hopped over the stick of Couturier, and the Leafs will counter. Led by Ritchie over the line. Nylander across. Morgan Rielly had Ritchie in front, and the pass was denied. Now Marner's on the move. Here's Mitch Marner working his way in and dropping it off to Matthews. Ritchie looks for space in the slot. Rielly at the point. Back to Matthews up high. Now Marner, side of the net. Nylander, Rielly. Matthews. Morgan Rielly fires into the glove of Hart with 39 seconds remaining in the Flyers penalty.
Well, an odd man rush on the shorthanded play by the Philadelphia Flyers. Just an errant pass there by Nylander. That creates the chance. But watch Austin Matthews. Gets a little bit pressure from behind, and Jack Campbell does a nice job of putting that rebound a little bit further. So unable to get a hold of it. Here's just a shot through, trying to find a little tip, and nobody in front of the goaltender to get it.
Faceoff won by the Flyers, and they play it back inside the Leaf line. Rasmus Sandin. He'll kick it back, and here comes Jason Spezza. Over the line with Engvall and Bunting. Wayne Simmonds, the former Flyer, also out there as Engvall whipped that shot wide. Funny hop, and It'll be a clear by Cam Atkinson. So a pair of shots on the power play so far. One last invasion of the Philadelphia zone. Puck along the boards for Bunting. Cycles it back towards Spezza. He got tied up there with the official and lost possession. Referees tonight, Dan O'Rourke, along with Trevor Hansen. Bouncing puck on Campbell, left in front. And Lawton out of the penalty box, chasing after it. There's James Van Riemsdyk, the former Leaf, out on the ice as well. And Andre Kasha back for Toronto, sends it down into Flyer ice. Speeding after it is Semyonov. Here's Muzzin's shot, that's off target. Semyonov with a goal and 8 assists in 9 games with the Marlies in a good preseason where he had 3 points in 4 games. We thought he was noticeable in the exhibition game.
Yeah, absolutely. And, you know, for a lot of players, those exhibition games don't mean a lot. But for a youngster or a guy trying to get a position in the lineup, it's the only thing that you have early on to make an impression on the coach. And what a great opportunity here with Tavares out for him to get a chance to prove he can play at this level.
Matthews feeds it ahead. Nylander unable to reach that. Sanheim, the Elkhorn, Manitoba native, played it back into the Toronto zone. There's Bunting in a battle in front of the Leaf bench. Now Brody off the boards and a hit for Bunting, who sidestepped the check. And here comes Nylander trying to cut in. Unable to get anywhere there, but it comes across for Matthews. Back to Brody at the line, looking for a shooting lane. It ricochets to the near side for Riley. Tied up there by Couturier. Nylander in front. That one deflected off a stick and passed Riley. Back to Morgan Riley at the line. Good Leaf movement here. That hit Matthews, comes back to the line, and it's held in by Riley once again. Leafs start to change as we approach 6 minutes of this opening period. Giroux sends it in. Konechny overskates it. And Kerfoot's out at center to Marner, and now Liljegren. Timothy Liljegren puts it right on, rebound. Richie backhanded that wide. Marner able to hold the zone. Puck bouncing in the slot, Richie fires right on. So 20's had a couple of looks so far in the early going as he moves up in the lineup in the absence of John Tavares. Back it comes to Liljegren. His shot off a stick in front. And it ends up out at center. Marner has to hold up to keep the play onside. Konechny back to Justin Braun. Braun up ahead, that's over the stick of Joel Farabee. Now Provorov, the former Brandon Wheat King, sends it in. Jason Spezza and Muzzin along the boards, comes to the line. Here's a chance in front of the backhand by Atkinson, stopped by Jack Campbell. So a good start in this one. We played 6:54. And the Leafs with 7 shots, the Flyers 4 so far.
Seen some crazy moments. Let's take you back to November 10th, 1996, 25 years ago today. Ron Hextall and Felix Potvin throwing them. This is old school Philadelphia Flyers hockey. And Felix Potvin hanging in pretty good against Ron Hextall. This is a moment I don't think any hockey fan will ever forget. Guys, that is old school.
Old school enough, I thought it was the Spectrum because they had some scenes like that. Might have been the first split decision ever for Ron Hextall. Like Felix Potvin surprised him that night. There's a shot going wide of the net. No Ryan Ellis again for Philadelphia, one of the off-season acquisitions by the Flyers, who's not quite ready to go. They played back to the line here, and Keith Yandle sends it to the side of the net. Atkinson a whack at it. Now Farabee upended, and the fans react. The officials do not. Played up for Kasha as Kemp and Kasha get crossed up. And Derek Brassard, who also scored against Washington in their last game, a win in the U.S. Capitol. Here comes Engvall back the other way. Kasha to the net, the backhand. And that's off the glove of Carter Hart. I don't expect a Carter Hart, Jack Campbell tilt tonight.
No, I can't imagine that happening at all. And boy, that matchup of that five, the Kampf line with Muzzin and Hall has had their troubles with that Broussard line. That's two in a row that they've been hemmed in their own zone and created a couple of good chances. And it's been the work along the boards that the Flyers have been able to keep alive. And that's a couple in a row now. Hall and Muzzin haven't quite been able to get things organized and just trying desperately to keep everything to the outside. When it did go the other way, there's a backhander that one you just got to try to put across the goaltender to get a rebound.
A blast from Provorov, deflected just off target. Bunting trying to get it out, and Matthews followed up. And now TJ Brody up on the right side off Nylander and into Philadelphia ice. Matthews on the forecheck. There's Provorov off Giroux, steered it for Konechny, and then Nylander gets it back for Toronto. Pretty good pace so far. Richie dumps it down into the Flyer zone as the Leafs change, and back out comes Kerfoot, centering this line with Marner and Richie in the absence of John Tavares this evening. Tavares missed seven previous games as a member of the Leafs. Leafs with a 3-2-2 record without him. At the line, Ristolainen shot is deflected back out to center.
Just the disappointment is he was skating the best he had all season long, and as you saw, a lower body injury, just probably one of the reasons why he was really testing it out this morning. You hope that it doesn't take that speed away. It's always hard to recover from those. You don't get to train the same way.
Marner in front, Richie hits the deck, and Carter Hart pounces on the puck.
It's game time. Order all your favorites with Skip the Dishes. Let's get hungry.
I mentioned Craig McTavish talking about Nick Ritchie getting his chance, and you slide down the lineup. He had his chances early on. Nothing been able to get any traction. You know, the one thing he's been able to do, Chris, is hit. I mean, if you're in the lineup in that role, you've got to do it. But this is your chance to show you can make plays, get the offense going, and desperately, this team needs some offense other than the three top players who are in it.
Leading hitter on the Leafs with 29. You mentioned Craig McTavish. You and McTavish were outstanding in the Kevin Lowe banner-raising ceremony last week in Edmonton. Here comes Muzzin across from an angle, and that shot stopped by Carter Hart. We've seen Jason Spezza practice his lineup about five pucks from that angle and hit the far corner every time.
Yeah,
so
it seems like a long shot, but it's actually not. You can get a good view of that, and I think Carter Hart had some respect for that, Chris. He was able to get across quickly and anticipated that a shot might be coming from deep in the corner.
Matthews had trouble corralling that puck. He lost that puck. Here's a shot by Broussard. It's knocked down in front, and now Bunting will head north. Here comes Matthews to work over the line. He'll drop it off. Nylander, Bunting. And Braun got a stick on that. Back for Nylander. Morgan Riley across. TJ Brody looks rink wide, and that went off a skate and nearly went in. Back the other way. Broussard will just steer it down the ice and get a Philadelphia change.
Well, the destination of that pass was going to Nylander, though, and he might have had an easy tap in had that puck not hit the skates of Austin Matthews.
Engvall sends it around, and it comes back to him. In behind the net is Kasha. Andre Kasha sitting on 99 NHL points. Unable to center that against Ristolainen. Now it comes free for Kampf. Engvall and Kasha had his stick lifted, and the puck back to the Leaf line. Brody tracked back there by Giroux. Rink wide Kampf neatly taken off the skate to Briley and played into the Flyer zone. Shots are 10-6 Toronto as we await the game's first goal. Scott Laughton, the Oakville product and former Oshawa General, out there now, along with Oscar Lindblom. Richie at center, taps it over to Lilligren. Here's Timothy Lilligren firing it. Carter Hart got a piece of that, wasn't sure where it was, and that one deflected out of play. So Timothy Lilligren stepping up. Leafs want their blue liners on the attack a bit more. And that one off the mask and out.
by Tylenol Rapid Release Gel Caps. It was a busy offseason for Chuck Fletcher and the Philadelphia Flyers, making a handful of moves. And he spoke to the media recently saying, we just can't keep bringing back the same players back year after year and expect different results. It has been a great start so far for the Flyers, and unfortunately they've been without Ryan Ellis for a handful of it. He had a great start so far on his new team. The good news for the Flyers is that he's expected back in the lineup in a matter of days, guys.
Certainly one of the prime acquisitions by Chuck Fletcher. Cam Atkinson, another one that was an interesting deal, trading away Jake Voracek. Here's a steal and a break back the other way for Philadelphia. Coming back in a hurry with Sandin to try and thwart that. Patrick Brown plays it back to the line. Here's a shot that Campbell stopped that with Nate Thompson and Sandin jousting at the side of the net.
Sandin lost that physical battle, didn't he? Thompson just ran him right over, but credit Campbell. He was able to fight through the traffic to his left and get on that shot and get on the rebound.
Patrick Brown was out there. Now a turnover, and Konechny just missed. Here's Semyana playing it back out to center. Spezza trying to work his way past, and it'll be a penalty against Spezza as he interfered there with Giroux to make the move, and the Leafs will be shorthanded.
Well, you finally get out of pressure and you end up taking a penalty, but this is Liljegren just not recognizing the danger there. Tried to make one too many plays, but good job Sandin taking the angle away and keeping them to the outside. And here's the little hook back there. Giroux sells it well, but it's reaching around with the arm right in front of the official, and the arm went up quickly.
Well, the Flyers are the 13th ranked power play in the league, 1-for-10 in their last four. The Leafs now 10th on the kill. And Philadelphia wins the draw in front. Couturier, big stop by Campbell on Couturier on the doorstep. And now Marner starts out. Breaking here is Camp right on. And Couturier will fire it around to the near side for Konechny. Leafs killed all three on Monday against Los Angeles in November. They are 10-for-11 in a penalty kill roll. Now Philadelphia gains the line. Puck popped onto the stick of Marner, and he'll turn them back.
Not a lot of speed on that entry, and a good job of pressuring once they gain the zone. And the Leafs outman them, got good active sticks, and able to force them to come back and try all over again.
Without Ellis, Provorov is the point man on this power play. Konechny sends it around. There's Provorov and Giroux. 3 points on the power play, shy of the Flyer record held by Bobby Clark for Claude Giroux.
That'll be quite an accomplishment, won't it, ever to reach that pinnacle of a player that's Hall of Fame status here in Philadelphia.
From one captain to another, Giroux, the captain of this Philadelphia team for the last 11 years. Out comes Farabee. Rolled in, and Farabee after. Puck popped out in front, and Engvall's going to get there first. And knocked off his stick by Van Riemsdyk, but Engvall gets it back. A solo mission deep in the Philadelphia zone. Engvall trying to spin away from the traffic, and now plays keep away neatly. Hall will dump it back in, and there's just a dozen seconds remaining in the Spezza penalty. Under six left here in the first. And Jake Muzzin will finish off a successful Leaf roadkill.
What an ending shift by Engvall there. He's got the crowd going against the home crowd, but didn't be risky with the puck. Kept it down low, didn't throw it away blindly, and killed a good 15, 20 seconds off.
There's a turnover, and Campbell had to come across quickly and knocked down that with his glove. Well, they got a chance right off the hop on the power play. And Sean Couturier was parked in front. He got robbed by Jack Campbell. No score here in the first. Different storyline this year. The Leafs were the best first period team last year. Philadelphia was the second worst, but this season, Flyers have been good for the first period. The Leafs, not so much.
Yeah, and the early tracking as well, even 5-on-5 scoring. The Leafs were plus 36 last year. To this point, they're minus 5. The Flyers were minus 26. They're plus 9, 5-on-5 to start this season. They've been a tough team to play against, even strength.
Flyers 6-2-2, trying to bounce back after a tough non-playoff year. The theme here in Philadelphia is something to prove. An icy call against Toronto.
You know, in Philadelphia, there's a short leash for coaches. There's been plenty of those over the last 10 years. But Alain Vigneault, the disappointment of last year and all the disruptions, I think now his team, though, he had training camp. He's got some new bodies, as we just mentioned. And Chris, I think on the back end, they got three new defensemen that are all 45-plus point guys in their career. They have the ability to get some good offense from the back end.
There's Lawton trying to center. Lindblom had it knocked off his stick. And Bunting turns back. Michael Bunting on the ice with James Van Riemsdyk as well. And Bunting's talked about being influenced by Van Riemsdyk and his work around the net. Here's Brody turning into the corner. Matthews trying to come out from that corner as he is tracked and shadowed by Justin Braun. Matthews has his pass off, Van Riemsdyk it out. Flyers changing. Matthews looks like he wants to get off too, and Riley sends it deep. Under 4.5 to go here in the opening period. That one will skip past Lilligren and back down into the Leaf zone. Reversed here to Kerfoot, up at center for Richie. Lilligren's on the move. Couldn't take that pass cleanly. Now Ristolainen will take him to the end boards. Here's Atkinson chopping it back out to center. Mitch Marner works his way back, a 6-game point streak. So without Tavares, the longest active point streak for Toronto now belongs to number 16. Sandin to Hall. Justin Hall gets to the red line, sends it in, past the stick to Hart, past Simmons. Muzzin followed up, tried to get it back to Simmons. Now Spezza steps in, and it's Semyonov playing it back to Hall. A double clutch and a shot wide. Jake Muzzin fires, and that's right on with Simmons on the doorstep. Wayne Simmons, twice a 30-goal man here in Philadelphia. 29, a couple of 28-goal seasons, a 24-goal campaign, and 8 very prosperous years with Philadelphia. And Simmons on it again. That pass hit a leg and rolls back to Campbell. Engvall at center. Giroux was there. Hall tries the other side. Off the stick of Kampen in. Kasha on it. And his shot hits Sanheim. Here's Giroux, and he is tripped up by Kamp. And the Leafs are going to be shorthanded for a second time in this period with 2.5 minutes to go.
Providing competitive odds on all sports, Sports Interaction is Canada's odds maker.
You can see David Kamp yelling at Giroux. Giroux's the one that's been able to draw both penalties. Earlier it was the arm of Spezza. This time it's the right leg. And you just felt that Giroux was expecting to get some contact there. Instead, the contact didn't come high. The contact came low. And once again, a foul right in front of the official. And Giroux has been able to draw two. He's getting yelled at from everyone. Spezza just gave him a few words as he went by as well.
Giroux stays out there with Couturier and Konechny. And that puck dropped unfairly. Spezza going to get waved here.
Yeah, he is. And so now Mitch Marner.
He doesn't want to leave.
David Kamp would be the one typically taking a lot of these draws, as Spezza hasn't been taking as many as of late.
And the Flyers control. And it's threaded through down low for Couturier. Around it comes for Atkinson. Leafs found it. And Marner with the clear. So Provorov starts back. at a 17-goal sophomore season. Hasn't been up in that area since. Travis Konecny tried to play it back. Kerfoot was there. Kerfoot off his stick trying to set up a teammate, and now it was bobbled by Provorov. And the Flyers making a change, and Morgan Rielly can just wait it out here and now play it down the ice. 50 seconds gone in the camp penalty.
You've done enough games here, Chris, to know that when your power play is not going well on home ice, the home ice crowd can be a real deterrent. They get on you pretty quick and get you squeezing your stick maybe a little tighter than you need to.
Here's Van Riemsdyk playing it back, and was going to say this city has a low patience threshold.
Yeah, you can hear it now. The Bluebirds are out already. And only the second power play.
The city known to boo Santa Claus. Yeah. So your power play better work. And right now it's not. Now Semyonov chasing after. Carter Hart's got to come out and play it away in the final minute of this opening frame, and a couple dozen seconds remaining in the David Camp penalty. Nylander lost it, but it slides to Rielly and Brody. And now Semyonov to Nylander. And offside the call with just 11 seconds left in Toronto's second penalty of the period.
Well, Sheldon Keefe talked about the Monday night game. He said, you know, Saturday night we had a divisional rival, the Boston Bruins, on Hockey Night in Canada, and our team was up. We were energetic. We took control of the game, even though we got down 1-0 Monday against a Pacific Division team that you hadn't played forever. We just didn't have it in us. We were late to the show. We weren't skating. And I'd say here has been a bit of combination of both. They've killed two penalties. They've made some mistakes. Still had trouble scoring in the first period, but it's been a pretty good effort on the road.
Matthews knocked that down neatly, but taken back by Lawton with under a half minute to go. Scott Lawton works his way over the line. Shot right on by Lindblom. And Nylander's got it, and he'll turn back. Good to see Oscar Lindblom back, and happy to report cancer-free after 2 years ago being diagnosed with Ewing sarcoma. And the period's going to come to a close. The shots are 12-11 Toronto, and we await the game's first goal. Carolyn Cameron coming up with our first intermission. We're in Philadelphia tonight. It's Wednesday Night Hockey, scoreless after 20 minutes.
Period. A lot has been made about the Maple Leafs' relaxed dress code. Well, the traditionalists will be happy to know that everyone was wearing ties tonight, although Austin Matthews putting a little bit of a spin on his outfit with the Spartan green Nike dunks. And how about this? John Tavares letting the ankles breathe. Not often you see John Tavares without socks, maybe taking a page from Austin Matthews' book. A night off for John Tavares, but the socks also taking some time off, guys.
No socks and no goals in the opening 20 minutes.
The pressure of being a player nowadays, you get criticized for what you wear into the rink. It's such a different game than it used to be.
And Sean's going to have a report on the Flyers style, or okay, as they like to call it, their drip, which is a term at least one old guy up here was really not that familiar with.
No, I'll make that too. I had no idea of that one either.
So more to come. Stay tuned as we start the second period. Leafs outshot the Flyers 12-11 in the opening frame. Shot attempts 18-16 Toronto. Engvall at work deep in the zone, and there is David Camp on it. Kasha trying to make himself available, and Cam Atkinson turns back. Atkinson had 6 goals in the first 6 games as a member of his new team. That one is going to be frozen by Jack Campbell. More fashion from Sean McKenzie.
Well, guys, you mentioned drip, and well, this is drip. It's a term for style, but not maybe the style that you're used to. A little bit of newer age Gucci tracksuits, velour tracksuits, some odd camo pants. Now, this was a night out in D.C. for the Flyers, and they decided the theme would be drip, and who has the most of it, and basically means who would wear the most ridiculous outfit to team dinner. I think they accomplished that.
Apparently, Claude Giroux did not have it, and apparently even he's old for drip at 33.
For those pictures for Craig McTavish and I. That's a Halloween party.
Back to the line for Brody. In deep from Matthews, tracked by Provorov, a centering pass denied. Matthews wins another board battle, trying to get it to Bunting. Along the boards, and Brody seals the wall for Toronto. Justin Braun had four block shots in the first period. Out there as Bunting looks to center. Riley came down, but the pass didn't arrive. Some good work deep in the zone for Matthews, sweeping in front. Carter Hart got a pad down just in time as that was ricocheting into the net.
I don't know how that one didn't end up in. Hey, Carter Hart's looking to his left, and it's his right pad that just gets the end of this puck. Nice job of Matthews, aggressive play, and it's just hooked right around in his pad, but he has the presence of mind. Goes off of Bunting, and then right there underneath him, he could feel it, and he was able to get his pad out instead of getting pushed back in, and that's a heck of a reaction save with all kinds of traffic in front by Hart.
Hard to believe that didn't drip in.
Good one.
Face off won by Scott Lawton, and right back on the puck. The Leafs have some jump here early in the second period. Marner tried to hand it off, but the connection was not made with Liljegren. Here's Kerfoot looking rink wide. That was broken up. Here comes Lindblom. Liljegren gets back. Battles along the board with Lawton. He takes it away. Centering pass. And that shot didn't have a lot on it from Van Riemsdyk. And Campbell holds on.
You know, you think of Campbell's game and so much talk with back-to-back games Friday and Saturday. You have to feel that you're going to have an opportunity to see either Hutchinson come back up or Wall get his first opportunity. But Campbell, good bounce-back game. You know, he had a couple on Monday that he felt he should have had. Here, he's been razor sharp, and a reason why neither goaltender has allowed one in. They've both been very sharp to start this game.
Tried to take the blame for the loss against his old team, saying he cost his club 2 points. I don't think anybody else saw it that way. Here's a shot that's blocked, and another goes wide after Kerfoot blocked the initial shot. Moving up to Sanheim, lost it there, and it's chipped ahead. And Marner will play it off the boards and out.
So you think, Chris, though, this is a game. You know, you get back on the road after a long winning streak. You need some of the role players to get an opportunity to contribute. It's been all the top four guys that's been much talked about, and here is a typical game where you need a boost from somebody else, and it might be the first goal that gives you that boost and gets the rest of the team going offensively.
Everybody familiar with 14 straight from the core four, or three tonight, and 17 of the last 21 scored by four of the Leafs, the big four. Alex Kerfoot, the last non-4-4 player to score for Toronto. Here's Broussard looking to center. Atkinson works along the boards. Gets tied up by Muzzin. Matthews deep in his own zone. And now it's Wayne Simmonds scampering out to center. Simmonds trying to get by Nick Seeler, the former Minnesota Wild defenseman. And it's played back out by Philadelphia.
Well, there's another shift where Muzzin and Hall just really not able to connect and turn the puck over a couple of times yet again.
Back in, Couturier whipped it wide. Travis Konecny, the former Ottawa 67 for Giroux. Taken away by Matthews, who's upended, but play continues at the line. That shot knocked out in front. Nylander is after it. Then able to play it out to center and get some room. Here's Nylander working his way in. Looks cross ice and back the other way is going to be Claude Giroux. Justin Braun jumps. Konecny the shot and Campbell out beyond the blue to make that save. And Bunting spun down by Giroux after the whistle. And that's going to get a reaction and Konecny gets involved too.
Well, Bunting didn't feel that was by mistake. He felt that it was Giroux going after him. They're having some words here, and that's a quick reaction as he's coming back to the front. We've seen Giroux draw those two penalties, and here Bunting felt he should have had one. Here's the turnover that goes back the other way. Watch, Morgan Riley's going after the puck carrier. That opens up the trailer, but The key for Campbell, his great positioning out aggressively. There's the play. Yeah, no wonder why. As Giroux saying, oh, I didn't see it. Bunting saw it otherwise.
So face off to the right of Jack Campbell. Giroux has already drawn two penalties in the game. In front for Lawton. That doesn't work. And David Camp onto the right side. And it rolls down into the Flyer zone. Played ahead by Sealer and off Lawton. There's Lilligren. Leaves it for his partner Sandin. Gets it back to Timothy Lilligren. The third pair stays together even with Justin Hall back in the lineup. Here's the steal in front. Oh, a big stop. Carter Hart on the shot by David Camp.
Well, there is the opportunity for the bottom six to have an impact. And here's Camp right in the slot. Just good job on the forecheck to create the loose puck. But watch the hesitation by Camp. It's almost like he was waiting maybe for a split second to get cash on the other side. The quick release doesn't get high enough. And a great execution by Carter Hart to come telescoping out and take away the angle and got his pad down to able to make the save. That's one you got to put up in the top third of the net on that quick kind of release off of a turnover.
Carter Hart had a disastrous season last year. 3.67 goals against, 877 save percentage, but we've heard how much better he's been and we're seeing evidence of it tonight. 14 straight for Hart as that one is sent wide of the net and chopped past Muzzin and out. Marner at center does some nice work and gets it to Muzzin and plays it back in. Spezza hounding Ruotsalainen. Spezza stays on Ruotsalainen, who had three hits for the Flyers in the opening period. Ruotsalainen hits the deck. It'll come back to Hall at the line. That's knocked down with Kerfoot or perhaps Sanheim as they were tied up together. Worked back to the line again. Hall holds his own. Now it's Spezza in front of the net. Kerfoot right on. And Hart's got that.
JackpotCity.net. Casino games perfectly made for you.
If you heard Craig McTavish off the top of the show, he said there'd be a short leash for Richie. If Sheldon Keefe didn't see what he'd like, he'd make a change early on. Here's one change to begin here in the second period. Spezza gets on with that line, and he creates a good chance and another good scoring opportunity with an excellent save by Carter Hart.
Matthews, Nylander, and Marner together here. Marner after it against Provorov. Cycled down, Matthews looks for it. Provorov trying to move it ahead. That was knocked down by Marner and now out of center. Here's Konechny over the line, snapped it high. And it bounces past Provorov and back out. Here comes Marner, 10 points in his last four. Morgan Rielly swings wide. Nylander across, big shot, loose in front. And cleared away, but Nylander's got it. Back to Rielly. Here's Marner, and a shot by Matthews right on. And it's nearly held in by Matthews. Finally, Philadelphia moves it ahead. Konechny on the move and tried to slide a sneaky backhand in, and it went wide of the net.
So Keith's juggling gets back-to-back offensive zone chances with Spezza, and then all of a sudden this line as well, and there's one that hit. Is there going to be a playoff penalty or just a whistle?
Whistle sounded as it hit the Leaf skate going to the bench.
That's like somebody it hitting their glove. He's half in and half out, so he's out of play.
Canada continues their bid to qualify for the 22 FIFA World Cup. Tune in to Canada Costa Rica Friday 8:30 Eastern, 5:30 Pacific on Sportsnet and Sportsnet Now, and full house at Commonwealth in your home in your home city.
Yeah, a lot of excitement there as Alphonso Davies getting a chance to play at home for Canada. And Chris, here's again, good job of Keith shuffling the deck a little bit, gets Richie back on, and this is one of those shifts where you try your best to try to make an impact and make something happen.
Second shift of the period for Nick Richie, who's got the puck, comes out in front and tests Carter Hart with his third shot on goal so far tonight.
Well, you kind of feel for both goaltenders that you're going to have to get one where he doesn't see or get a deflection, because when it's one-on-one so far, both Hart and Campbell have been excellent. A little hesitation here and a quick turn by Richie, but that's a tough angle with a goaltender who's staying square and didn't really give him much.
From the draw, scramble in front of the net, taken away there, and Sanheim will look up ice. With Salinen off Van Riemsdyk. Gene Van Riemsdyk, 6 years at Toronto Maple Leaf. Over that span, he led the Leafs in goals. Salinen at the line. Back into the corner it goes. Flyers trying to spend a little more time in the Leaf zone in this second period. And here's Sanheim winding up and blockered away by Campbell. Comes back to Sanheim again, the former Yellowhead Chief. And it comes around to the near side. And the Leafs getting hemmed in here at the moment. Sandin tried to flip it back. That hit a leg, but now he's able to force it out to center. And Richie will get it down into the lead zone. Richie ripped the helmet off Ritsalainen and kind of tossed it back at him. It's going to be a penalty.
At the end of the shift, you got hemmed in your own zone. You finally get it down deep and get a change. And now Richie's going to find himself headed to the penalty box.
Not quite the Nathan MacKinnon helmet toss, but it's going to be a minor penalty. And the Leafs have taken their third of the game.
And not a penalty you see very often, is it? And this one is, Richie realizes, here's just the frustration here. Gets hit now. The fact that even if he hadn't have held on to it, I think he might have been able to get away with it, because it's a little bit of a battle, but you've got it in your hand. And holding on to it, if it had just fallen off, you might have been able to get away with that kind of motion to the back of the head. But the fact that he held it for a couple of seconds made him guilty.
So the Leafs giving this Flyers power play a third opportunity in the game. One shot on goal so far in the first two. And Philadelphia now 6-for-30 on the season. As Giroux gets waved, Couturier will step in. Atkinson, the fourth forward. And Keith Yandle, the Iron Man, will play the point. And on it, this Atkinson, there's the veteran Yandle.
Nick Richie in Toronto.
933rd game, and that shot from Atkinson goes wide. Here's Yandle, whoa, to get up, Atkinson again, and Campbell got enough of that. Up against the boards, Muzzin with a outlet, and it will be flipped away by Camp.
What a great play and read by Muzzin there with that pressure. He had a little no-look communication with Marner and made the nice little pass to alleviate the pressure.
And a good stick there by Justin Hall, back in the lineup and averaging over 3 minutes per game when in the lineup on the penalty kill for Toronto. Bump back for Giroux, 9 minutes into the second. Still awaiting the game's first goal. Morgan Rielly behind the net, Kasha in support. There's Atkinson. Brody a chance to clear it. He'll send it 200 feet.
Good example of coordinated pressure there on the entry. All four guys working in unison, and the Flyers just not quite quick enough to make those little support passes to get the setup.
Camp spells Kasha out there along with Engvall. Rielly took a whack at that. After this Farabee, Van Riemsdyk's out along with Broussard now. Second Flyer power play unit. Brody, like he tried to tap a pass to a teammate, but it wasn't read, and now to an open wing and out.
Well, this power play for Philadelphia has just been out of sorts. You said coming in they've been on a bit of a dull run, and this game, the third one, hasn't looked much or any better than the first two, has it?
Yeah, 1-for-12. into this power play halfway through the second period, and that's going to do it. They're going to be 0 for 3 on the night. Back in, and Campbell steers that shot away. Van Riemsdyk drops it off. Lawton covered the point, and that one deflecting into the corner off the stick of Zach McEwen, the former Vancouver Canuck. Lilligren ahead, Nylander to work. Over the line, Matthews, his shot off the stick of Braun. And Philadelphia sends it to center. Rasmus Sandin back to Nylander. William Nylander in a four-game point streak. And again, all of his goals have come in the third period or overtime so far. Here's Hall loading it up. That one knocked out in front. Still loose, and Nylander unable to reach it. It'll be swung out to Hall with a stick there to get it to Bunting. On to the left side, Matthews. Muzzin jumping. Muzzin centering it. Scores off Nylander, but it will be wiped out as it was kicked in.
And an emphatic response immediately by the official. Trevor Hanson was automatically, he's going to make the call.
No goal. The puck was kicked in.
Oh, boy. Boy, I'm not sure. I don't. That a kicking motion?
Well, does his skate even come off the ice? I don't think Nylander's skate even comes off the ice. Watch this if you can see any separation or kick. Oh, he lifted up. I think this has got to be a challenge by Sheldon Keith. You know, it happens in real time. It's difficult for the officials watching through all the bodies, but
if I read his lips right, he said not even close, so he's pretty confident.
Yeah, this one's going to be a goal.
Should be a goal.
That is.
He,
I mean, the telltale sign is that his blade never even comes off. I think Nylander knows that it's going to hit him, but he doesn't really make a kicking motion at all on that one. So I think it's going to be a 1-0 game here for the Maple Leafs. And the reaction was almost after it,
yeah,
he was told.
Well, Phil Deneau scored a goal the other night. It went off his skate twice. And there's a confident Leaf fan, and I think a confident Leaf coach, that it's 1-0 Toronto.
Yeah, there wasn't much of a hesitation from the Leaf bench as they looked at it. And I understand the safety part, but kicking motion, no way. I'm shocked it's taken this long, actually. How about the little saucer pass there by Matthews inside, and all Muzzin's doing is trying to direct it towards the net. Here's the end result from the official.
After reviewing the play, it's determined the puck was deflected off the skate, therefore we have a good goal.
So Trevor Hanson changes the call, and the Leafs do have the lead on the sixth goal of the season for William Nylander.
And the 15th straight goal from the core four of this Toronto Maple Leafs. I mean, you'll take it right now. This is such a critical time, and watch the little layer pass there by Matthews. Go to the net hard. You know, the old saying is go to the net with your stick on the ice, good things happen. I guess you don't always need a stick to put one in the back of the net.
William Nylander not wearing a poppy, but Remembrance Day goal at 11-11.
Kind of fitting, isn't it? Unreal.
Toronto goal scored by number 88, William
and
Nylander.
The Leafs with a 1-0 lead as they score first here tonight. Patrick Graff back to the line. Yandel shot. Zach McEwen after the rebound. Fourth line for Philadelphia trying to get some energy back, but now Simmons with Semyonov. Here's Semyonov trying to get it back to Simmons. Semyonov played in all 7 years in the KHL and at least 3 years with Ilya Mikheyev. And that's how he got spotted. When the Leafs were scouting Mikheyev, they took note of Kirill Semyonov as well, icing against Toronto.
Well, the hot streak continues for the top guys, and now the key here is keep the momentum going. Interesting, right after the fourth line gets a chance to keep that momentum going, and that's where Sheldon Keefe trying to work the entire bench and make sure everybody feels a part of it. You never want to sag after you finally get that one goal. And ice time becomes an issue with three games and four nights. The top guys have been overtaxed, and without John Tavares in 20 minutes, you got to try to distribute it a little bit differently.
From the drop, roots the line and sends it in. There's Konechny, a pass in front, it skipped past Giroux. Roots the line and moves up. Around to his defensive partner, Sanheim. Into the high slot, here comes a shot that's walked in front. Leaf bottled up, Brody rejects a Konechny shot, roots the line and it bounced on him. Unable to get one away, but now Sanheim up top at Giroux. Rich Lalinen into the slot, and a stick by Semyonov to break that up. The Leafs are hemmed. It's a loose stick lying in the Leaf zone, and now Toronto gets it out. And flying after, it's Kerfoot, and his shot sailed high. Kerfoot again, the last non-core four player to score for Toronto. Here's Nick Ritchie, unable to center that. Sanheim moves it ahead, Konechny up, and Giroux blows a tire in front of the Flyer bench.
Go away!
Pass knocked down by Couturier, a counter here. Couturier, and he just missed the target on that setup by Farabee. That stick still causing havoc in the Leaf zone. Allowed Sandin to move it ahead. Lilligren just got rid of it in time as Broussard was on the forecheck. And now Lilligren off the boards and out. Ritchie redirects it and goes after it against Farabee. Kerfoot, Farabee knocked down by Ritchie. And that gets a crowd response here at Wells Fargo. Up off the skate to Broussard. A shoulder check by Muzzin. That pass comes back to the line for Ritsalainen. His shot teams direction and bounces just past the net. That looked a little dangerous. Now in front for Broussard. Here's Broussard. Sanheim shooting wide. Hot rebound off the inboards, and Hall trying to get it out to center, and does. And now Matthews with Bunting. Rink wide. Nylander. The goal scorer, William Nylander, swings wide. Second in the league and shots on goal. Only Ovechkin with more. And now passing it to Riley. Morgan Riley in front, off the ski to Matthews, and back the other way goes Van Riemsdyk. Getting back is Riley. Van Riemsdyk dropped, and Campbell got a piece of that with Lindblom bumping into him. Lindblom in front, and that went off him, and Riley clears to the boards.
What a read by Riley to get back so quickly. Just kept on a straight line, kept coming as far as he could, got a stick in there and helped out the play at the net.
Camp out there along with Engvall and Matthews, and now the puck out of play with just under 5 minutes remaining here in the second period. It's Scotiabank Wednesday night hockey, and here's some great work by Morgan Riley on the back track. Last, there it was against Detroit. Third goal for the Leafs in that game.
Yeah, quite a game where Kerfoot got one, Muzzin got one as well. That's the only defender to score for the Toronto Maple Leafs this season at all.
And there is, on the season, a shooting percentage of 11.4 for the big guys. The other eight at 6.3%, and in November it was 2.7%. Not been a high volume of core three shots tonight, just four. Two for Matthews, two for Nylander. And Mitch Marner has yet to register a shot on goal. Trying to get away was McEwen. And it's Sandin recovering for the Leafs. Up there on the right side, glove down by Semyonov. His shot goes off Yandle to the corner. Zach McEwen up for Nate Thompson. And Patrick Brown unable to catch up to that. waiver pickup from the Vegas Golden Knights, and we saw him play a dozen games in the postseason last year for Vegas. Here's Yandle. Closing in on the all-time Ironman record of Doug Jarvis. 31 games shy of that. After registering his 933rd consecutive game here tonight.
Right here.
Pretty incredible that that record is somehow going to potentially be broken. I thought that was one with Jarvis that just seemed jaw-dropping, but nobody could get in that many straight, especially in today's game, too, with the speed and the tempo.
Here come the Leafs speeding in an Engvall, testing Carter Hart. That will even the shots at 19 apiece here. One's gone in off the skate of William Nylander. NHL moment on that live trip.
Well, what I like here is you're 26 years old, you played in the KHL, you know that the eye in the sky is watching every shift. And so, to me, okay, you get hit, maybe didn't expect it from McEwen, but you popped right back up, you gave him a shot back, and you realize that you've got to find a way to compete and show that you're not overwhelmed in this situation. And all things considered, it's been a pretty solid effort by him to this point.
Don't think your first game's ever easy. Maybe a little easier when you're 26, when you've been a pro, when you had a number of preseason games. You remember how nervous you were for game number one?
Yeah, game number one is always a little unnerving as an 18-year-old, but you're right. The expression of understanding the what's expected of you in a role. I mean, you're not coming in and playing on the top line, so you better be physical, you better keep your legs moving, you better control the puck, even there, stop up, get it towards the net, don't make risky plays, and part of that understanding of what the coach is looking for will give you the opportunity to stay in the lineup.
Just over 3 minutes left here in the second period. Around it comes to the far side for Sanheim. Hall off him, and it ricocheted to Lindblom. Hall blocks it at the side of the net. A scrum with Campbell hugging the post. Back to big Travis Sanheim. Ruotsalainen on the other side, pumped by Richie. Kerfoot couldn't move it along, and Sanheim's got it again. His shot got through, and Campbell lunging out to cover up on that rebound. Post-whistle gathering, and now a message from Wheel of Time.
The Dark One's army is coming.
And Jack Campbell having a few laughs with the officials. Another great read of Campbell through traffic and able to make that save and saw it at the last second and then jumped over to the side, and that's what created a little meeting of the minds there as the Flyers came in with the sticks and Hall answered back.
Campbell 12-6-3 on the road as a Leaf netminder, looking for his first career win against Philadelphia. Allowed 4 goals in each of his previous 2 starts against the Flyers.
There hasn't been much not to like about Campbell's games all throughout this season. And you mentioned that he tried to take some responsibility of a loss on Monday against his old team, but he's given you what you need here and active in his crease and seeing the pucks through traffic very well.
Just got some help from Austin Matthews. Kick save and a beauty by 34 on that oncoming shot. Morgan Rielly flips it out to center, knocked down by Couturier. Dashing back in is Konecny. And Matthews on him. Played back to the line. Provorov in some difficulty there with Nylander. And now Nylander into the Flyer zone. Flips it through for Bunting in front. And Matthews unable to get good contact on that. Back goes Couturier. Justin Braun jumping, and Morgan Rielly gets back again. With Braun going to the net. How about Braun? More points as Couturier bounces it in. More points already this year than all of a full last season. So he's been more active with the Flyers and has 7 points after a 6-point season last year. Atkinson. Now Yandle. That pass ricocheted onto the stick of Semyonov. Trying to send away Kemp, and it's an icing call against Toronto.
We saw the earlier back check as Morgan Riley gets a pat on the rear end from Muzzin. He's in thinking offense, and all of a sudden you've got a double pinch and he gets back to the middle of the ice. The key there is always come back with a direct line towards the front of the net so that the puck has to come to you. If he goes down and tries to pursue where the puck is, it's an easier pass to go over. Instead, just come right back through the middle knowing that that puck's got to come to you sooner.
Riley has to stay out. He's been out a while, and that pass knocked down by Semyonov. It rolls through to Campbell. Camp after it, working against Brassard. Now Sandin undercut the pass for Farabee. Farabee works the corner, and that comes around to the near side. Here's Sandin, opposite side of the net, put it in front, and Wayne Simmonds there to take it away in the final minute. Rolling it through and a burst by Semyonov, but a backhand goes wide. David Kemp to the far side. Matthews let it go. Lilligren sends it back in towards Matthews. He'll come out in front. Up high, Jake Muzzin, and he'll fire that over the net. Matthews is on it. Austin Matthews got a little room. Back to Lilligren. Lilligren. And now Muzzin a shot that cuts down Kasia in the slot. Lilligren moves up. Engvall covers the point. His shot is knocked down in front. It hit Kasia again.
He got one on the instep, and then that one as he's trying to get position in front. He ended up making the save, and he's gone right to the room.
Yeah, he was hopping on one leg down the ramp to the dressing room as the horn sounds to end the second period. 11-11, the time of the goal here in the second. William Nylander gets it from Muzzin and Matthews. Leafs will take a one-goal lead to the third period on Scotiabank. Wednesday night hockey with our second intermission coming up.
Rep Our Home is brought to you by Molson Canadian, our beer, hockey's beer. Now, the surname Hart has always held a special place in Flyers history. First, it was legendary broadcast voice Gene Hart, then his daughter Lauren with her incredible anthem rendition. And now 2016 draftee and Flyers last line of defense, Carter Hart. A native of Sherwood Park, Alberta, Hart was a star at the World Junior Championships where he struck gold. As a teenager, he won numerous awards in the WHL and Everett with the Silvertips. But now he is the present and the future of the Flyers. And it was Flyers legend and two-time Cup champion Bernie Perrant who said Hart is the man to bring the Cup back to Philadelphia. Now let's send it back to the guys in the booth.
Well, there is Carter Hart, who's made 22 stops tonight. NHL Edge IQ is powered by AWS, the official cloud infrastructure provider of the NHL, tracking puck possession tonight. A couple of Flyer defensemen at the top of the list, and then a couple of star forwards for Toronto.
It tells you a little bit about what drives each team, and it is the forwards for the Toronto Maple Leafs, and so often Provorov is at the forefront defensively for this Philadelphia Flyer team as well. He can do it in so many different ways. This is a great challenge at a critical time now with a couple of big games coming up on the weekend. Can you hold a one goal lead going throughout this third period on a road in a game you feel you want to win to get yourself back on the roll that the Toronto Maple Leafs had?
Got those road warriors, the Calgary Flames, in for the Hall of Fame game on Friday, and then the Leafs make the trip to Buffalo for hockey night in Canada on Saturday, trying to win their 6th in 7, but still 20 minutes away from that.
Now the Flyers have
more.
The Flyers have been used to playing these low-scoring games as well. One goal against or less in 3 of the last 4.
Flyers with points in their last 7 home games against Toronto, and a glove stop early in the period by Campbell off Provorov.
Well, it's those kind of every shot has a chance. And Campbell, I think the key here is when he has been screened in front, he's been able to battle through and not only make the save, Chris, but control the rebound. And there's one where you can't make a change, you lose a draw, you stop it, get a rebound, and now Sheldon Keefe gets Matthews out, which is a better matchup.
On that draw, the Leafs come up with it, and it's flipped in by Bunting. Michael Bunting after it. That's the seventh defensive zone draw taken by Austin Matthews tonight. In the absence of John Tavares, he's had to take more, usually averages about 2.5 a game. Backhand swept across. Here's Braun, and a blast wide, and it boomerangs back into the Philadelphia zone.
Well, that was a bad break for Campbell there. He made the save and put it to a nice area, but it hit the referee, and that opened up that second shot by Braun, because the puck, instead of clearing away, hit the referee's skate and went right into the wheelhouse of number 61.
Muzzin and Hall on the back line. Muzzin ahead, and Ritchie will flip it in. Sanheim whips it around. There's Hall with a quick close, and it comes back to Justin Hall. Hall again chops at it. There's Scott Laughton working against Muzzin in the backhand wide. Van Riemsdyk, Sanheim, shot blocked by Marner. In behind the net, Laughton, far side for the former Sabre Ruotsalainen. Justin Hall, short pass for Kerfoot. The Leafs come out. Off Kerfoot's stick, Muzzin will play it to the right side for Ritchie. And he wants a change as he sends it down into the Flyer zone. Wayne Simmons comes out. Semyonov back on the ice with Spezza. An errant pass picked off by Lilligren. And Simmons gonna hunt the puck deep in the Flyer zone, and he takes down Ruotsalainen. Now Sandin activates. In behind the Philadelphia net. Off the boards from Farabee, and Semyonov will feed it back to Sandin. Lilligren back across. Sandin's got some room. Through center is Rasmus Sandin over the line. Bunting checked back in, and now Matthews will gather the puck and play it back to Brody as Sandin heads to the Leaf bench. Sealer and Gandel. He'll play it back to Nick Sealer, who didn't play at all last year. Here's a turnover. Leafs are in. Michael Bunting, and he whipped that just wide. Riley sends it across in front of the net. Matthews is on it. Scoops it through for Bunting. Works the end boards, trying to tap it for Nylander, and he intercepted there. And Keith Yandel lost the handle, and it goes to Nylander, and a glove stop by Carter Hart, with Bunting crashing into the net behind him.
Well, all kinds of chances off of turnovers. This is a great defensive shift by Austin Matthews. Three times in this shift, he was supporting up high and able to turn the puck over. There's one chance that creates an odd man rush that Bunting unable to find the back of the net on that one. Now you blow a wheel. Matthews right on the doorstep, and quick decision there by Nylander. He saw Bunting on the side, but knew the pass was taken away and tried to go up high over the glove of Hart, but Hart in great position made the nice save.
Nylander, the goal scorer for Toronto tonight. Spezza played it in front of the net. That was blocked by Braun. And Provorov starts the breakout for Philadelphia. Sent in by Giroux. Justin Hall with a shoulder check, and he was able to work it to Marner. And Mitch Marner trying to get it past Provorov. That's an offside against Toronto. Well, we mentioned Keith Yandel, who has been getting a lot of attention in his new team, and a lot of the Flyers saying he's the best teammate we've ever had, and that's a familiar refrain from teammates of Keith Yandel. And I couldn't help but think Jack Campbell gets the same kind of rating from everybody that's played with him.
Absolutely, and that goes such a long way to supporting your teammates. You got your back, you feel good about playing with him, you always want to support him, and it's a reason why Yandel can stay in the league as long as he has to, and one of the reasons why so many good things are said about Jack Campbell. And when you get a game like Campbell had against his former team where he started, you know that everybody wanted something positive to happen. Get another win, get six in a row. Well, that's not always the way hockey goes. And part of the responsibility of being a good teammate for someone who is a good person is to support them. And not just emotionally and talking to them, but in a game like this, shut the door, close it on, and make sure he gets back into the winning way and keeps his good, solid season going. Another similarity between the two. They're both scratch golfers. People saying Yandle a natural athlete, and Jack Campbell is too, and that'll be vacuumed up by Hart. Good to see Kasha back out there after he limped off at the late stages of the second period.
Well, this line has been relied upon by Sheldon Keefe so much in a defensive mind, and you know, as the one-goal game gets deeper and deeper into this period, you watch how Sheldon Keefe works his bench and deploys his players. Offensive zone faceoffs, maybe a change, but defensive, you'll see a lot of Camp taking draws and Matthews taking draws.
From the draw, Leafs get control. Bunting reaches for it, sweeps it back for Brody. Sitting on 49 career goals. Nylander trying to dodge the checking of Braun, who stays with him. But a penalty now coming up. Campbell's gone to the bench. Marner comes over the boards. Brody takes a look. Bunting had it knocked off his stick. And now Toronto will get a power play, 4:25. Into this third period.
It's a good battle in front as Bunting's trying to get inside position on Provorov. He gets a little frustrated and gets the stick up in the groin right in front of the referee. There's no question about that, but the battle prior to that, they were going at it pretty hard, and credit Bunting getting into that area, got Provorov frustrated. So not only do you get a power play, you get a key penalty killer sitting in the box in Provorov as well.
Ice issue at center that the officials want to work on, and the Flyer logo. And there's a pretty good conversation going on between Bunting and is that Travis Konecny? The end of the Flyer bench.
Well, it's not Claude Giroux, because he's having a discussion with the official down on the ice too. So you remember earlier on, they were going at each other. Anthony was talking about the setup here, and for Nick Ritchie, he's getting a little talk from Nylander here to say, okay, this is the one guy who doesn't really fit how this power play, which had been going so well. You know, you try to replace John Tavares, you're not going to do the same thing. So simplify it for him. Get your position in front. Try to take away the eyes of Carter Hart.
Matthews got control. Marner in front. That's stopped by Hart. Nylander couldn't reach it for the tip that looked like Marner was intending. Marner got it back to Riley. Moving in. Nylander gives it back. And they'll work it to the near side for Matthews. Ritchie parks in front. He had 5 power play goals of his 15 last year in Boston. Trying to provide a screen with that big body in front. And now it's Riley walking the line. Nylander down low. Quick shot. Ritchie stopped by Hart in that bumper spot. A pretty good look. And now feeds it. Nylander scores. Power play goal. William Nylander from Nick Ritchie, who has his first Leaf point.
Not lost on the rest of the players. You saw Nylander, I mentioned the fact he was talking to Ritchie, so you put your plan together. Matthews comes, gives him a good pat on the back. Go down to the side. This game, last game, was Marner to Tavares, and it ended up in the back of the net. That's a heck of a save, but he keeps the play alive. Down low, Ritchie with the backhand pass, just perfectly placed. And give it to the hot man. Nylander just continues to be able to beat goaltenders with one-on-one shots. That little wrister on the blocker side makes it a 2-0 game.
Second assist for Nick Ritchie. Pardon me, his first on the power play. And the second goal of the night for William Nylander, who now has 7 on the season.
And you know, what's critical there is these critical moments of the game. You get a bad penalty from a leader of the Philadelphia Flyers in Provorov, you gotta take advantage of it. You gotta make them pay. And this is good puck movement, a real sense of purpose and urgency. They kept the puck alive twice, and then the end result, One good chance from Richie, a great save by Hart, and then that one off the stick of Nylander continues his hot streak. That dump in there had a little cracked glass, so we'll be back in a little while.
So while the Wells Fargo crew works on the glass, we will step aside. You're watching Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey from Philly. First two-goal game of the season for William Nylander, doubling down tonight.
Well, just off to a heck of a start. He's on a five-game point streak. This was the little bit of a fluke one, but one that gets you going. And then just great execution. And as I mentioned, his ability to beat goaltenders one-on-one this season has been razor sharp. One of the most shots on goal in the National Hockey League, and he's off to his best goal scoring start, career high 31 a few years ago, but looks like sky's the limit here. And you know, I talked before about being a good teammate and supporting each other. After that goal goes on, he got plenty of conversations, a little crack of a smile, a little pat on the head by the leadership group of Muzzin. And everybody knows, you go to a new team and things don't go well, man, it starts to weigh on you. You can't help but feel for the guy. Players like him as a person, his work ethic is good, and you just hope that you can get something to contribute to feel a part of it. And you saw the reactions there off of a well-executed play and a nice pass by Richie that finally gives him a little belonging and confidence in his new team and a new lineup.
Dawn Power Wash saves you time from scrubbing dishes. Simply spray, wipe, and rinse to clean as you go.
Four shots on goal for Nick Richie in the game. And just prior to the Nylander goal, Carter Hart came up big to thwart Richie's chance for his first Leaf goal.
Yeah, the only thing would have been better if he buried that one like Tavares did the game before.
Matthews gets an assist as well on the power play goal. So the Leafs now 7 for the last 14. And if there are no more power plays, the penalty kills tonight, the Leafs likely would end the evening in the top 10 in both special team departments. Here comes Farabee back, or Atkinson, excuse me. Atkinson along the boards. Now Farabee follows up with Brassard. David Kemp there defensively. Comes back for Yandle. Slides past Kasha. Farabee in front, Campbell down, and he stopped that redirect from Atkinson on the doorstep. Jamming along the end boards, it's kicked loose. And Liljegren, with some help from David Kemp, able to work it out, and back down into the Flyer zone. 6:20 gone in the third, both teams making changes. Marner back out onto the ice as it's redirected by Lindblom into the Leaf zone. Brody, outlet for Kerfoot. Now Marner looking rink wide for Richie as it slides down into the Flyer zone. Kerfoot after it there. Richie crashing in. Marner knocks it down, and they're going to call that a high stick. But the Flyers generating a chance at the other end, as Cam Atkinson was on the doorstep.
A little hesitation here, as typically after the 14-minute mark as a commercial, everyone was anticipating it because of the glass break. We took it earlier, so we're back to play.
Puck sent down the ice. Jack Campbell out to play it away from McEwen. There's Spets ahead, and here comes Simmons, maybe a two-on-one. Brody couldn't get ahead of Zach McEwen there, who did a good job of tracking back for Philadelphia. Nate Thompson ahead, Simmons at center. Spezza redirecting it to Semyonov, who one-handed it behind the net. Here's the Alaska native, Nate Thompson. McEwen crashing in there. Muzzin trying to dig it out from his skates. Sanheim moved upside of the net, out in front, and Simmons knocks it away. Flyers defenseman going to take some chances now, down by two, approaching the 8 minute mark. That one gloved down, taken by Couturier to the far side. Justin Braun's in deep. Skipped past Couturier, but there's Provorov on the move. Couturier behind the net, looking for Drew. Now back to the line for Sanheim. Konechny, a nifty pass that almost worked, but the Leafs clear to center. Flyers trying to push the pace. Konechny with a drive, stick side wide. And back out to center it goes. Travis Konechny's got a man loose. Giroux fired that. And Lilligren with a good stick to deflect it out.
We've talked so much of the key players for the Toronto Maple Leafs and what impact they can have when they're scoring. Look at this trio. And here again, William Nylander with a pair tonight. His Leaf record when he puts one in the back of the net. We haven't seen the net tickled with the twine by Mitch Marner or Austin Matthews, but Nylander, you can just see how successful and how big a part they are of the wins for the Toronto Maple Leafs.
From the draw, comes back to the line, and that's shot. Whipped wide of the net. Here's Farabee up top, but Campbell saw that through the screen by Atkinson and Sandin jostling in front. Farabee to the point, knocked down by Brassard. Punching there for the Leafs, and able to work it out. And offside called at the Toronto line, but the Flyers are pushing now.
Yeah, you would expect that. And you mentioned it's their D being active and staying up tight. They're making a lot of plays at the line to keep the puck alive. And any shot is a good one. You mentioned Campbell not really being able to see that one through a crowd. That puck ended up in the corner, Chris. He was still looking in front of him to find out where the rebound went. He never really saw it.
First of three between these two teams this season. We'll have to wait for the next one. It'll be April the 2nd. And they wrap up on April 19th. Bouncing puck at center. Kasha's on it. Engvall with him. In front, Engvall! And he couldn't get the shot away. And back the other way comes Philadelphia. Lawton is hauled down and a penalty coming. And Lawton looks like he's in some difficulty, slow to get up. But it was also a slow reaction by the official on the call.
Yeah, well, you could see the 3-on-2 developed here. Now all of a sudden you're scrambling to go back. And this is a play where Kasha just got inside down. And oh, it's the second hit after, but I believe the arm was up on the initial play right there. And he got his stick underneath his legs, undercut him, and then got another little hit back the second time.
Well, the Flyers get their fourth power play of the night. Camp on this face-off, Marner out in a penalty-killing role. Giroux wins it for the Flyers. Yandel's on the point. Giroux watched by Camp. Shakes that check. Couturier fired. Hall with the block. And Konechny shot doesn't get to the net. Justin Hall trying to clear it. Couturier to the far side. And it's Giroux. Swinging it back to the line. And now Couturier right on. Rebound. Camp. He got caught up in the skates of Hall and couldn't get a backhand clear away. Van Riemsdyk so good in tight. Out there is the net front presence. He'll give it to Couturier and go to the front. Couturier shook off the checking of Camp. Gets it back to Yandel. Oh, Giroux! His shot stopped. Rebound. And Yandel's going to step up and claim that. Now loose puck, and Camp will swivel and fire it down the ice.
Another example of Campbell coming out of his crease to get close to where the traffic is and fight his way through. He made two excellent saves where he had a hard time tracking that puck coming to him.
Past the midway mark of the period. Kerfoot now out with Engvall. As Sanheim and Farabee work over the line. Brody knocked down Farabee, and the puck ends up on the screen.
Well, of the four power plays, this has been the most effective for the Philadelphia Flyers. And They get puck movement out high, side to side, and there, just the timing of Van Riemsdyk. He went by and gave the eyes back to Jack Campbell. Another one with a couple of blocks and a really good active stick to not allow that rebound that was sitting there get its way back to the Leaf netminder.
Two shots on this power play so far. 39 seconds remaining. Spezza on the faceoff against Brassard, and it's won by the Flyers. But Jason Spezza comes up with a puck at the line, is able to play it back into the Philadelphia zone. Spezza to the bench. Kerfoot comes back on. And here comes Farabee. He has a pretty good nickname here in Philadelphia called Philly Joel. And Farabee near the side of the net. Play stopped. Is that a hand pass? It's going to bring the faceoff outside.
Yeah, no, I just think it was Jack Campbell was going to put his glove over it, and the referee was anticipating it, but Farabee got there before, so the play actually should have stayed alive. It's not really there. I was for a second, so the timing was okay, but you could tell the Philly fans were reacting to the quick whistle.
...13 seconds remaining in this power play. Fans reacting to that as well. As the power play to this point has let Philadelphia down tonight. Penalty kills been good, and Marner able to swat that one out. Under 9 left in the third. Couturier back in. Matthews with a one-handed swipe at the puck. That one was deflected past Campbell onto the post as the penalty's done. But the pressure continues. Couturier to the near side. And now it's Giroux surrounded by Marner and Matthews. And a stick came up on Marner. And he went down in a heap. And now the Leafs are going to get a power play. Will it be 2 or 4? Man advantage coming up for Toronto. After a big penalty kill by the Leafs. Captain Claude Giroux.
Just an errant stick, a quick little turnaround, trying to make a play on the puck. And Giroux, who drew the first two power plays for his team, gives another opportunity for the red hot power play to try to give a little bit more of a cushion here. And the same unit that scored the last one starts.
Something you never said in October, the red hot power play.
Funny how that goes, isn't it?
Great pass, and Matthews missed the target. Ritchie across, Carter Hart down, and he takes another one away from Big Nick Ritchie.
He can't believe it. This is just a scramble play coming back to the net as the puck goes from behind. Side to side, works hard, makes a great save there, and then look at the athleticism, gets the glove down. Ritchie steps in front of Nylander, who might have had an open net and be able to hit it, but Ritchie got it towards the net, and somehow Hart got the glove down and able to make the save.
Flyers control the draw and send it down the ice. Nate Thompson's out in a penalty-killing role. As the other 44 on the ice takes charge for Toronto. Skates past Thompson, who doesn't want Riley's pass to come back, and now the Leafs get in. Provorov intercepts, and now he'll take off. Here goes Ivan Provorov to the attack shorthanded. Matthews skates with him.
Well, Matthews taking no chances there. Didn't want to leave a one-on-one with his D. Come on the back pressure. You know that Provorov's just basically by himself trying to create something there, so doesn't allow him the opportunity to do so.
Offside at the line. With 67 seconds remaining in this fourth Leaf power play.
You know, you look up and you say, okay, I've got D back there, but you just don't want to leave anything to chance. Don't allow maybe a blown tire or someone to fall or a great individual effort. Instead, you chip it away and you start all over again.
So now Spezza comes out with Engvall, Bunting, and Simmons. And Rasmus Sandin to quarterback things. Off the stick of Spezza, will try and track it down. Engvall after it, center. Wade Simmons stopped by Hart. as Simmons has a great chance against his former team. Not his first game back. He was here three times as a New Jersey Devil after leaving Philadelphia. Engvall's got it down low. Simmons gives it back. Bunting in the slot. Sandin fanned on that. And now Lawton back the other way. And now he'll take the scenic route back into his own zone.
Well, if you're the Flyers right now, you're looking at your goaltender and saying on their bench, let's go get one for him. He just shut the door on basically what could have been two goals. Giving you a chance with 6:43 left to stay in this game, try to get one and close the gap.
We have seen the Carter Hart that has been on Team Canada radar. And we've seen as Kerfoot swoops around in front, and Kasha scores! 100th NHL point for Andre Kasha, and it's the first non-core four goal for Toronto in quite some time.
And it's not going to be a power play goal, as Giroux was just coming out into the play and a little late to get there, but it's the entry. Getting the loose pucks, good effort. Kerfoot coming around in that high slot. Look at how Kasha took his angle and came out a little higher so that that passing lane was available. He was in traffic, gets out of traffic, and just rips one high over the blocker. Good heads up play by Kerfoot and an excellent shot. Get the right knee down and back up and make sure he got everything he could on that in the top third of the net.
So after 16 consecutive goals by the core four, Andre Kasha has his second as a Maple Leaf.
Well, I like his, as Konechny got a stick in the face there coming down. It's watch how he realizes he's in the traffic, get in that quiet zone, and all Kerfoot is doing is trying to buy himself some time to see if anybody's open. Here's, oh, he ran into the official. That's why the official blew it so quickly too. He got head into the hip area right by the bench, and not looking all that comfortable on the bench is connecting. Kind of snapped his neck back, didn't it?
So he gathers himself at the bench. And taking his spot on this line will be Atkinson. So Atkinson joins Couturier and Giroux. That one punched away by Campbell, who lost his goal stick in the process. Puck comes out, and that gives Campbell time to retrieve his stick.
The second goal of the season. The assist, Alexander Kerfoot.
Kerfoot gets the lone assist. Here comes Simmons. Back in, Wayne Simmons across, and couldn't find Spezza. Sheldon Keefe has talked more than a few times about Kasha, how well he thinks he's playing, but also that he believes there is offense there, and he's a guy that has scored 20 in a season with the Anaheim Ducks.
Absolutely, and those instincts of the 20 goal scorer were on display there. You know, not much has happened for him offensively, but you can see that's just an excellent read of understanding where you can get open and then firing one as effectively as he did.
One goal on 32 shots coming in, so that has been about the shooting percentage of the bottom six guys. Muzzin ahead off the stick of Matthews with under five to go here in the third. Shots are 30-27 in favor of the Flyers. But it's the 12th two-goal game of William Nylander's career, and Kasha has given that lead a booster shot here at 13:33. There's Ritsalainen, and a club stop by Campbell looking around the screen in front. Andre Kasha ups the Leaf lead with 4:31 to play. Well, it's early, but the Miami Heat off to a terrific start. They beat the Lakers in Los Angeles tonight. Our coverage is just underway on Sportsnet 1 and Sportsnet Now. Justin Hall back out there with 4:31 to go. Your thoughts on his return tonight?
I thought a shaky start as the pair, but they've survived. First few shifts, he and Jake Muzzin had a hard time getting the puck and making those little plays, a couple of turnovers. You know, you're trying to work so hard and get yourself back in the lineup after missing five games. Sometimes you overwork yourself, but when you look up at the scoreboard, they've survived it all and did a good job on the penalty kill when they had to as well.
Sheldon Keefe talking about Hall getting a reset. His absence from the lineup longer than originally planned. Faceoff won by Kemp. Muzzin trying to clear the zone. It's held in. Provorov shot is blocked by Hall. And played back inside the Flyer line.
This is your late push lineup here for Alain Vigneault. We're putting Provorov and Yandle, two offensive-minded defensemen, together. And of course, we saw Konechny get hurt, so you put Atkinson out with Couturier and Giroux.
Weston Hall now with four block shots in the game. Kasha works the boards. He hits the deck. Provorov up with a puck. Ivan Provorov in front, and a quick glove by Campbell to grab that with Atkinson on the doorstep. And now a message from Yellowstone.
You're John Dutton, aren't you?
Yep.
Once again, reading the traffic in front. Atkinson's just trying to chip this one up and knock it out of midair. He knows he's in too tight that he can't pull it around, but Campbell reaches out and makes the save.
Jack Campbell with his 11th start of the season. His 11th start last year came in game 41 of the season. So the workload will be much heavier as long as health permits. At the line, in the zone by Farabee. Around it comes, Spezza takes a hit to make a play, and Kerfoot for Marner, just inside the line. And now back for Brody. Across Riley, Spezza's in front, but they'll play it up high, and Marner will drill that. Rebound for Kerfoot, a whack at that, and Carter Hart stops that. Hart has to retrieve his stick in behind the net as Sanheim advances. Konechny back out there, knocked away from him by Morgan Riley. 3:03 left in the third. 3-0 Toronto.
Good thing Hart went and got his stick behind there. I don't think Provorov even knew he didn't have it because he fired that one back to his goaltender.
Sandin's got Lawton bearing down. Lawton working the end boards along with Lindblom. Richie back on the ice. He's had five shots on goal tonight. On a line with Semyonov and Simmons at the moment. Here comes Liljegren. Richie Liljegren, stopped by Hart. Richie to the net, and Hart's got that. As Liljegren looks for his first NHL goal, and Richie still looking for his first as a Leaf.
Well, one of the guys who'll be looking for some answers after this game is Alain Vigneault. You look at a couple of key penalties in front of the net. You got two of your leaders that take a bad penalty. The Toronto Maple Leafs make you pay on the power play as Provorov's penalty went in. Then Giroux just gets out, and all of a sudden you're down by three instead of one, which was a tight game. Alain Vigneault won't be happy with those two penalties that derailed his team here in the third period.
And with 2:22 to go, down by three, he's got his fourth line out there, which is making a statement.
And you know, this team has done a pretty good job. They haven't lost two games in a row this year, but they've yet to be able to get to three wins in a row. And that's kind of the litmus test for all teams. You try to put some strings together of that, and we'll be interested to see how they respond as they've got a couple of busy scheduled games coming up as well, much like the Leafs, a couple of back-to-backs.
Yeah, they're on the road in Carolina and Dallas coming up. That shot knocked down in front, bunting ahead. Home free, looking for the hat trick. Nylander, glove stop by Hart. And a little fumble might have cost him that great scoring chance.
And way too much time to think. You know, he got, okay, the situation is one as he's laughing. He sees the puck go down, knows it's blocked. Matthews up to Bunting, and he took a quick little peek just to see. He goes, yeah, I'm in all alone. Now, what am I going to do? Get control of it. And one little quick movement just sort of disrupted his feel for the puck, and he can't help but sort of sheepishly smile and shake his head on the bench. That would have been a great moment with the hat trick on the line.
Next goal for Nylander will get him into the top 50 all-time in Leafs scores, drawing even with the legendary Ace Bailey. Here's David Camp playing it back into the Flyer zone. Down to the final 100 seconds of the night as Engvall puts another shot on goal. Shots are now 33-32, Philadelphia. Lawton leans on Kasha. Sanheim on the move. Drops it off for Van Riemsdyk. His shot right into the glove of Jack Campbell with a tap for TJ Brody.
Wow, what this game does for Jack Campbell too is just, again, let everybody settle down. There's no thought of any teammate of Jack Campbell's that he's not able and willing to be the go-to guy. He's handled it extremely well in a game that he knew he had to bounce back and get his team right back on track. I thought he's just been exceptional at fighting for the puck, making saves in traffic, and it's been a great night for number 36.
There's Thompson along with Brown and McEwen out there again, and Campbell very cool with the traffic on the doorstep.
Well, I think the key is his eyesight. He's tracking the puck well. Even when he does have that traffic in front, look at stand up, look around it, feel that he's got some pressure on the outside, and then a good active glove and no rebound again there for the Flyers player.
Betsa wins that faceoff. Sandin around. There's Richie with it. Mentioned five shots on goal for Richie. He had four in the previous five games. Wayne Simmons over the line. Richie stepping in on the left side. Final minute, third period. And only one thing left to be determined. Richie unable to tuck that in, and the Flyers start back. Yandel lost it at the line. Out of the reach of Richie at center. And a Go Leafs Go echoing through the Wells Fargo building, which is emptied out for the most part. Off Campbell there on that shot, and a quick clear by Hall. And this one is just going to miss the net. It's an icing call.
Yeah, right now you're playing for your goaltender, and that's about it. You know, good bounce back effort on the road to start a 3-4 nights. Now all of a sudden, instead of any questions of, okay, was that 5-0 run just a little bit of a blip on the radar, or now they're right back to 6 wins in their last 7 and feeling pretty darn good about their overall game.
From the draw, Kasha pounced on that, rolls it down the ice. Down to the final 15 seconds. You saw the graphic. Justin Hall with the puck. Leafs have not shut out the Flyers here in Philadelphia in 19 years. Not since Belfour, but Jack Campbell's done it tonight with his second shutout of the season and the 6th of his career.
And like Craig McTavish was talking about, trying to win those defensive-minded games that you're going to need come playoff time. You go on the road in a hard building against a team that have been playing pretty darn good hockey, and you do a great job defensively and get some timely offense with a power play goal as well.
So here are tonight's Molson Canadian 3 stars. William Nylander, a pair of goals, and now with 7 on the year, one on the power play. Jack Campbell kicks out 36 for his second shutout of the season. And look at Nick Richie, up to 7 shots when the game was done, and an assist on that clinching power play goal. Leafs next game, the Hall of Fame game, on Friday against Calgary. We'll have them Saturday in Buffalo. Right now, we say so long from Philly. Here comes Sportsnet Central with Avaca and Campbell.